start next chapter. Next chapter is some applications of trigonometry. Some application of trigonometry. So that means where we can use the trigonometric concept. So where we can use the trigonometric concept? Suppose assume that this is one tree. Assume that this is one tree of length as much. So can you find the height of this tree? Yes, you can measure. How we can measure? By using scale or tape, right? So you can measure this height of the tree or this height of the scale, right? Suppose if it is mobile tower. Mobile tower, you know mobile tower, right? So is it possible to find the height of that mobile tower by using scale or tape? No, because it is too high, right? It is too high. So we can't find the height of the mobile tower by using scale or tape, right? If it is scale or if it is normal, yeah, if of this height or if it is like this. You understood, no? So the scale measurement we can do, because the height we can measure by using scale. The height of object where we can't measure by using scale, in that case we have to apply the trigonometric concept. Clear, no? That only I told. I gave example. Suppose this is your tree and which can be measured by using scale, right? This can be measured. What is the height of this? Suppose it is tower, we can't measure it directly. Such a case we have to apply the trigonometric concept. So how to apply? Assume that this is your tower. This is your tower. So which tower it is? Mobile tower. It is mobile tower. Assume that this is your mobile tower. I need the height of this mobile tower. Height of this mobile tower. How to find the height of this mobile tower? So by scale we can't measure the height of that tower, right? So now by using trigonometry, right? How to find this one? Suppose assume that here is observer or here is observer. Here is one person, right? So first, assume that is one person. So now, so from here, he is looking to the top of the tower, right? This is called line of sight. This is called the line of sight. From here, from his eyes, from here, from our eye level. That is called the line of sight. And from here, eye level. So this is the line. This is line. And it is called as horizontal level. This is called as horizontal level. Okay. So if you join the horizontal level, the line of sight will get one right angle triangle. Correct, no? This is your right angle triangle. Clear, no? So this is mobile tower. This is mobile tower. I need height of that mobile tower, which we can't measure by using your normal scale or by using your tape. In such case, we have to apply trigonometric concept. So how to measure here? We need here line of sight at horizontal line. How to measure? Assume that the person is standing here. He want to calculate. This person want to calculate the height of the tower. Clear? The height of the tower he want to calculate. That's why he is standing here. So person is standing here. So how to measure? From his eyesight. So he want to see. He want to measure the height of the tower. So he is seeing the top of this one. From eyesight. So from here, join this one. So that will be what? Horizontal line. Clear, no? So from here, from his eyesight. Not from here, not from here, not from here. From his eyesight, the draw the horizontal line. And this is your line of sight. Understood, no? So if you join this, you will get what? One right angle triangle. And here is one angle. Here is one angle. This is person or object. Normally we are saying as object here. okay, object or person, and that is a cup. And this is called as angle of elevation. This concept is very important. What is your angle of elevation? Angle of elevation is, if line of sight is, above the horizontal line, then the called as angle of elevation. So angle of elevation is angle made by this object, or this person with the foot of the tower which is joining to the object, So this is called as angle of elevation. Next, suppose person is standing here. Assume that person is standing here. He is standing on some stand, right? He is standing on here. And suppose object is here. This is your object. Suppose object is here. So he want to calculate what is the distance or at what height the object is here. That you have to calculate. How to calculate this? So this is his eyesight. From eyesight to the object join the line. So that is called as what? Line of sight, right? Line of sight. And there is one horizontal line. So which is a horizontal line? From your eyes, from a line of this, this is called as horizontal line. If you join this, so you will get one right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. And angle is what? Angle is always between horizontal level and this line of sight. Horizontal level and this line. So this is theta. This is called as angle of dispersion. Angle of depression. So clear now? So your main concept is whether it is angle of elevation or angle of depression. I give one example. Suppose I'm standing here. I want to find the height of this scale. Correct, no? So how to find the height of this is, I am seeing lights. So that means if my eyesight is towards upward, then it is called as what? Angle of elevation. If I see downward, my eyesight is downward. Suppose object is there. I want to find what is the height from the ground level to here. So my eyesight is towards downward. So then it is called as what? Angle of depression. So see the difference between angle of elevation and angle of depression. That is very important. So now after finding angle of elevation and angle of depression, so now here I am drawing a right angle triangle. Next is same. Suppose this is called as what? The height of the tower. So that is denoted as H. That is height of the tower, which is denoted as H. And here is object. So this point, from this point to this, is distance between. This is called as what? Distance between the tower and object. That is denoted as D. So here the distance between the tower and object, that is D. And this is angle theta. Suppose find the height of the tower. I need height of the tower. So height of the tower can be calculated by using formula tan theta. You know this is one right angle triangle means this is theta, opposite side. This is 90 means hypotenuse side and adjacent side. So tan theta is what? H divided by D. That means opposite side divided by adjacent side. H divided by D. So H is height of the tower. D is distance between tower and the object. Same thing I draw here. Suppose here is object. And here is a tower. Find the height of the tower. find the height of the tower. So how to find? Here is object, here is tower. So from here to the top, angle of elevation, and join this one. This is height of the tower. This is distance between the tower and the object, and this is angle of elevation. Suppose if you need height of the tower, use sine theta, because h divided by d, that is opposite side divided by adjacent side. Suppose if you need to find d, distance, what is the distance between object and tower? So distance d is equal to what? Again the same, that is h divided by d. Suppose it is angle of dispersion, right? Suppose object is here, your horizontal line. So this is your horizontal line, this is your tower, and if it is like this, so this is called as what? Angle of depression. So this is opposite side, this is hypotenuse side, this is adjacent side. So this is object and this is tower. So here d is the distance, this is height of the tower. So what is the formula? Opposite side divided by adjacent side. Again we can use tan theta is equal to h by d. So this is important here. So how we can find out the height of the tower? Height of the tower can be find by using formula tan theta is equal to h by d, that is height and distance concept here. So what do you mean by angle of elevation? Angle of elevation is if your eyesight is above your horizontal line. If your eyesight, suppose this is eye, so if your eyesight is like this upward, then it is called as angle of elevation. If it is the dispersion, depression means if your eyesight is like this, then this is called as angle of depression. Height and distance, sir, I explained how it is, but in notes write this part. Okay, this is your notes, but don't write that explanation part that I explained for your understanding. So this is writing notes, sir. Height and distance. So here is observer. So from eyesight only I'm taking, he is observer or object like this. Okay, object or observer. So normally they give object. Object is at a distance of 4 meters from the tower. So that time this is object. So next, he is observed. He want to calculate the height of the tower, right? So from height of the tower means from his eyesight. So he is looking to the top of the tower, that is called the line of sight. And from here, this is called the horizontal line. Horizontal line. So now this angle theta is what angle between the line sight and horizontal line. So this angle is above this horizontal line. This angle is above this horizontal line, or this line of sight is above this horizontal line, then theta is called as angle of elevation. This is called as angle of elevation. So now this is tower and height of the tower. This is mean height of the tower and this is the distance that I give separately. So this is about angle of elevation. So now here explanation. The line of sight is the line drawn. The line of sight is the line drawn from the eye, of an observer to the point in the object viewed by the object where he is viewed. Right? So from here to the point of view, so that line is called the line of sight. So next, the angle of elevation. Angle of elevation of the point view is the angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal line. The line, what it is? The angle of elevation of a point view is the angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal. The angle between the line of sight and with the horizontal line. When the point being view is above the horizontal line. The point is above the horizontal. The point is above the horizontal, or this beam viewed above the horizontal line, then it is called as angle of elevation. So write it in notes. Okay. So your notes of the sum application of trigonometry start from this, right? Height and distance heading. Next, draw this one. Next, write. Don't write the previous explanation. Okay. Next point in your notes. See, about angle of depression. So here is observer and this is object. Suppose that here is object. We want to find the height of this object from here. Right? How to find? See, he is seeing carriage, correct? Now this object, let me, and this is your horizontal line. And his eyesight is below this horizontal line. The eyesight is below this horizontal line, then it is called as angle of depression. So if it is angle of depression, that object must be the below of this horizontal line. Understood, no? The person is standing on this stand or whatever is the tower or whatever. He want to calculate the height of this object or distance of this object from him. So how to find, we have to measure like this, correct, no? So like this measurement. So how to find his eyesight is to downwards, means below the horizontal level. So then that time is angle of depression. Correct, no? So now this is the height of the object and this is the distance between the object and observer. Okay. So now next, this angle of depression of a point on the object B, B is the angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal when the point is below the horizontal. This point is below the horizontal. So here we can write object. This is object. The object is at what height? That you have to find. How to find? So by using angle of depression. Next, after those two, next write note. C note here. This is rectangle triangle. This is your height of the tower. Let it be h. And here is object. Here is object. You want to calculate the height of that tower from here. So how to find? So if it is, this is horizontal line. The object is, or the this object is on tower. The top of the tower is above this horizontal line. So theta is what? Angle of elevation. So AB is height of the tower, which is h, and BC is distance between the object and tower, and theta is the observer. This top of the tree is above, or top of the tower is above this object. So this theta is angle of elevation. In that case, how to find the distance, height, or angle of elevation? That is by using formula tan theta is equal to h by d. So if you want to h, rearrange this. If you want to d, you can rearrange. Then they will give what is angle of the elevation, and they will give height and distance. So sometimes they will give what is height with angle of elevation and this distance. So by using this formula. Next, if your object is here and observer is here, you want to calculate at what height the object is. So to find that, this is his horizontal line and this is object, and the object is below of his horizontal line, correct, no? Below of his horizontal line. So then, so this is called as what? This is angle of depression. So AB is height of the object and AC is distance between the observer and the object. And its theta is angle of depression because the object is below his eyesight. So here also distance or height or angle of elevation or angle of depression can be calculated by using formula tan theta is equal to h by d. So after those, write this first note and second note in your notes. Please learn this first question. It's very important for pre-marks. Important. The angle of the top of a tower. The angle of the top of a tower. So there is one tower. Answer. There is one tower. Okay. So this is your tower. Yes. Tower. The angle of the top of a tower to the top of tower. From a point on the ground. So from where the angle to the top of the tower? From a point on the ground, the angle to the top of the tower. Okay. Which is 30 meter away from this point is, which is means the point is. The point is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. So from this is point. This is point. The point is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. From the foot of the tower is 30 degree. So what is this 30 degree? Is that angle of elevation or angle of depression? So yeah, the angle of the top of the tower. The angle of the top of the tower from a top of the curve. So that means join this one. So this is your theta. Theta is how much here? It is equal to 30°. Find the height of the tower. Find the height of the tower means this is how much? So let it be h. Tower with height is h. What is this 30 meter? 30 meter is distance. V is equal to 30 meter. So you can name it as this is A, this is B, and this is C. Understood? Now how to write? This is angle of elevation. Why it is angle of elevation? This is your point. From this point to the top of the tower. From this point to the top of the tower, the angle is 30°. Means from here, here is point of object. Here is point of object, and this is a horizontal line. The top of the tower is above this horizontal line. Means this theta is what? Angle of elevation. So that is equal to 30°. Clear? What to find? Find height of the tower. Clear? No. So angle of, here it is not given whether it is angle of elevation or angle of depression. So by given data you can find out whether it is above the horizontal line or below the horizontal line. The angle of the top of the tower. So one object is tower. From a point on the ground, instead of observer, instead of person, here that is point on the ground. So this is point on the ground and this is the tower, which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. This point is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower, and that this is 30°. So how we can identify that is 30°? Because the angle of the top, angle of the top of the tower. So from here to the top means, so the angle is above the horizontal. Suppose your question is the angle of the bottom of the tower. Angle of bottom of the tower means angle comes here, right? So that time it is angle of depression. Here it is not clear. So it is angle of the top of the tower means above this one. Clear, no? So now how to find this one? So first time. So what is here from figure? From figure. So what we can write? Let AB be height of, AB be the height of the tower, height of the tower, which is equal to h. It is not given. What is the height? It is not given. Next is BC. BC be what? The distance between, distance between point, point and the foot of the tower. Foot of the tower. Tower which is equal to D. D is equal to how much? It is given 30 meters. And theta is how much here? Theta is angle of elevation. It's angle of elevation. Angle of elevation, that is theta is equal to 30. So which formula to use here? By using formula. Tan theta is equal to, tan theta is equal to what? H divided by D. How we are using tan theta formula? Tan theta formula is, this is theta, right? So this is what your opposite side. This is your what? Hypotenuse side. And this one is what your adjacent side. So opposite side and adjacent side. Height is opposite side. Adjacent side is distance. So these two are given. So which trigonometric ratio is better? That is opposite side by adjacent side means you can use a tan theta. Suppose if it is given, h and this given, then which trigonometry is better? That is h opposite side, this hypotenuse side. So that time which formula we use opposite by hypotenuse side, then we can use tan, sorry, sine 30°. So depending on given size, you can change the trigonometric ratio. Here it is given height and distance. That means opposite side and adjacent sides are given. So you can use the tan theta formula. So now we proceed. Tan theta. Theta is what? 30°. Is equal to h. H is not given. D is how much here? 30 meter. Now tan 30 is what? 1 by root 3 is equal to h divided by 30. So here find the height of the tower means you have to find what is your h. How to find now? Next cross multiply. 30 into 1 is 30 is equal. H into root 3. So in this chapter you have to rationalize. In the trigonometry no need of rationalizing. So but in application of trigonometry here you have to rationalize and you write the final answer. Okay, h is equal to 30 divided by root 3 and h is equal to, now rationalize, 30 divided by root 3 into root 3 divided by root 3. Rationalize denominator. So root 3 into root 3. So what is your answer? It is 30 into 3. Is it possible? No. So how to do this? 30 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3. So many times it is repeated. That is equal to 3. 3 ones are 3 times are. So h is equal to what? H root 3 meter. H root 3 meter is the height of the tower. So what is your height of tower? Height of tower is 10 root 3. So in application of derivatives, for your final answer, if it is possible to rationalize, you must rationalize and write final answer. In trigonometry chapter, it is not necessary of rationalizing. Okay? So that is 10 root 3 meter is height of the tower. Understood? Now how to find? So first, draw the figure according to the given. So what is the given? Try to understand the angle to the top from this. So the point is on the ground and tower is here. So that means from there to the top means the above the horizontal level. So it is angle of elevation. So which is at the distance of 30 meter. The point is at the distance of 30 meter. Distance is 30 meter. Find the height of the tower. Very simple, 4 or 3 marks important definite question. Next question. A tower is 100 square root of 3 meter high. So what is the height of the tower? Height of the tower is 100 square root of 3 meter. So one object is tower. Okay. So assume the picture in your mind. So there is one tower of height is 100 square root of 3 meter. Find the angle of elevation. So here it is directly given. Find the angle of elevation means two lights. Correct, not two upward, right? Of its top from a point. From where? From the point 100 meter away from its foot. So from a point which is 100 meter away from its foot. So now first I'll draw figure. Next I'll write what is given and all. So here is a tower is. So there is tower. This is tower. Okay, this is tower. A tower is 100 square root of 3 meter high. So what is height of this tower? A, B, D, a tower. So the length of tower or height of the tower is 100 root 3 meter. This is tower. Find the angle of elevation of its top. To the top. To the top, not down. To the top means your eyesight will be to the top. Right now, so that means it is angle of elevation from a point. So here is a point. From a point 100 meter away from its foot. From its foot means this is 100 meter. That is equal to distance. This is equal to what? H. Clear now? So now this is from this point to the top, the angle of elevation. So that means this is your theta. This is your theta. So question mark is theta. So if it is theta, so this side is what? Opposite side. This side is what? Adjacent side. This side is what? Hypotenuse side. So which trigonometry ratio is better? Here it is given opposite side, that is 100 root 3. And adjacent side is 100. Here hypotenuse side is not given, little bit. So opposite and adjacent means by using formula tan theta. So now we given what is we write. So from figure. So what is given? Let A B B. Let A B B the height of the tower. Height of tower. A B B the height of the tower. Which is equal to h, which is equal to 100 root 3 meter. Now next BC. So I take this point as a C. BC, B, the distance between point and point and the foot of the tub. Foot of the tub. Foot of the tub. That is D is equal to how much here? 100 meter. D is 100 meter. And theta is what? Theta is question mark. That is elevation. Angle of elevation. Angle of elevation theta. That is your question. Theta is question. So now its formula is to use. Using tan theta is equal to h divided by d. Tan theta is not given. Keep it as it is. H. What is our h? H is 100 root 3 divided by d is how much here? 100. D is 100. Right? So this 100 and this 100 cancels. So tan theta is equal to how much here? Root 3. Now for tan of theta, theta how much is root 3? Tan of 60 degree is equal to root 3, right? Tan 60 is equal to root 3. So therefore theta is equal to how much here? 60 degree is angle of elevation. Is angle of elevation. This is important for 2 marks question. 2 or 3 marks. Clear now? Tower is height of 100 root 3. Find angle of elevation to the top. So from a point which is 100 meter away from its foot of the tower. So by using formula that simplification and theta. For which angle of theta it takes root 3. So from here we have made the table. Tan 60 is equal to root 3. So theta is equal to 60 degree. Next question. A circus artist is climbing a 20 meter long rope. Figure is given. In question itself it is given figure. So climbing a 20 meter long rope. So what is the length of AC is rope, right? So from figure 20 meter. So what is a 20 meter? 20 meter is rope. So AC is rope. So now artist is climbing this rope. Which is tightly stretched and tied from a top of vertical pole to the ground. So from top of the pole to the ground it is tightly stretched. Clear now? This is rope and this rope is tightly stretched from the top of the pole. So what is this AB? AB is a pole, right? AB is pole and to the ground, right? Find the height of the pole. Find the height of the pole if the angle made by the rope with the ground level is 30 degree. So this is 30 degree given. So yeah, find the height of the pole if the angle made by this rope, angle made by this rope with the what? With the ground level. So this rope and with the ground level angle is the theta. So now how the figure is given, then it is easy. So in this writing difficult, writing figure is difficult. Writing figure is difficult. If you write the figure or if you draw a figure, then it is easy to simplify. So for that, read this properly and try to understand. Okay, here figure is given, then it is easy. So from figure. So from a figure, from given figure. Given figure. Figure, what is that? AC. AC. AC is. AC is length of rope. Length of rope. How much it is? It is equal to 20 meter. Next, what is that? AB. AB, what? AB is vertical pole. That means height of vertical pole. Height of vertical pole. Height of vertical pole, which is equal to h, which is your question mark. And theta is what? Theta is what? The angle made by. Is angle made by. Angle made by the rope. The rope with the ground level. with the ground level, which is theta is equal to 30 degree. Now tell me, is it elevation or depression? It is elevation. So this theta here is above the horizontal level. Now by using what formula here? What is given? What we need? We need to find. So if you draw figure again, so this is here 30 degree, this is 20 meter, this is H, that is question mark. So A, B, C, right now 30 degree. So now if you apply that ratio, opposite side, adjacent side and hypotenuse side. So which is better to use, the trigonometry ratio? So is it possible to use here tan theta? No, because opposite, adjacent side, about adjacent side is not given. Here given is hypotenuse side, and to find this opposite side. So opposite and hypotenuse side, so which formula you can use? So using any trigonometric formula you can use by using or by given, depending on given sides. So opposite and hypotenuse is given, so use side. Suppose opposite and adjacent is given, use tan. Suppose adjacent and hypotenuse is given, use cos or secant. Okay, so now using sin theta. Sin theta is what here? AB divided by AC. So AB divided by AC. So sin theta is equal to AB is how much here? It is not given. H, that is height. And AC is how much here? 20. And theta is how much here? 30 degree. Theta is 30 degree. Now simplification. Sin 30 is how much here? 1 by 2 is equal to H divided by 20. H divided by 10. 20. So 2 ones are 2 tens are else cross multiply. So 2 into h, how much here? 2h is equal to 20. H is equal to how much here? 20 divided by 2. So h is equal to how much here? 10. 10 meter is what height of the tower? Which is height of a tower. It is height of the tower. H is equal to 10 meter is the height of the tower. Clear this? So why I use the sign is depending on the given side, opposite and hypotenuse. Opposite side, that is H is to find, and hypotenuse side is given. They did not mention anything about adjacent side. So leave that side. So only concentrate opposite and hypotenuse side. So use the formula and give your answer. That is equal to 10 meter.